the condensed version of the Dharma Shastra, the road to realize the Puranic goal, is condensed by me. The Puranas and the Itihasas have bhakti as their central theme. But can we spend all the 24 hours doing bhakti, meditation and singing God's praise? No. We have to do our duty to the family. We have to eat, bathe, etc. and attend to personal and bodily needs. Even to devote the balance of time to puja is also not possible. Boredom sets in. We require, therefore, other directions and guidance to perform our good deeds. From where do we learn these? From only the Dharma Shastras of the 24 disciplines. What comes as the last after Puranas is Dharma Shastra. The characters from the Puranas show us the goal. What the Vedas have said at various places as to what our duties are have been arranged systematically and elaborated by the Upangas, household duties, personal work, bathing, eating have all to be done in order and as laid down in the Shastras. The Vedic Dharma has devised its injunctions so that all aspects of human activity are conducive to self-advancement and self-realization. Secular life and religious life are not separated by the Dharma Shastras. Secularism is also designed to lead to religion as per the Vedic Dharma. Whatever job is done, it is Dharma-oriented and is part of the exercise for the evolution of the self. Just as secularism and religion have been unified in the duties which the individual is required to do for his own salvation, the ingredients for social welfare, as also the well-being of the world, are inbuilt in the Dharma Shastras. Vedu Akhila Dharma Moolam, says Manu, the Vedas alone are the basis or the root of Dharma, of what are required to be done and how to do it. I am skipping a number of pages. If the Kalpa talks mainly of the area of the house plan, etc., the Dharma Shastra lays down the code of conduct for man covering all aspects of life. Smriti means an aid to memory. Vismriti means loss of memory. Smritis are aid memoirs for the Vedas. The Maharishis, who were perfectly informed about the Vedas, have compiled the injunctions and karmas, procedural details as to how to do them, and have presented them in an orderly manner. These smritis are written in a language which is easily understandable. Look at them. What you should do or should not do, how to do it, are clearly laid down in detail. The Dharma Sutras are concerned with the personal and social duties of the persons according to the jobs. And the stage of life in which they find themselves and acquired capabilities in a mature way and in a sattvic way. From time to time, a jiva enters into the mother's womb on to birth, growth, marriage, running the household, looking after elders, and at last to cremation. The smritis lay down all that has to be done in minute detail. It gives a chart which man should follow daily from the time he wakes up in the morning till the time he goes to sleep at night. There are 16 main samskaras dealing with the above aspects, so that the individual does not waste his time while he is on this earth. Manu, Parasara, Yajnavakya, Gautama, Harita, Yama, Vishnu, Sankha, Likita, Brihaspati, Daksha, Angiras, Prachetas, Samvarta, Asanas, Atri, Apastamba, Satatapa. These 18 Maharishis had grasped the contents of all the Vedas through their superhuman Shastra. Superhuman powers, and have given us their compilation in the form of Dharma Shastra. These are called Manusmriti, Parasara Smriti, Yajnavakya Smriti, etc., after the names of the rishis who compiled them. It is enough to study them. We can know all the karmas, anushtanas, and dharmas. In addition to the 18 smritis, there are 18 supplementary texts called Upasmritis. It is customary for Srimad Bhagavad Gita also to be regarded as a Smriti, although its contents are not direct quotations from the Vedas. Since it is an authority in support of our faith, it enjoys the status of a Smriti. I will continue. In my next speech,